Hi folks, Bob Collins for Diver Supply. What I've got here is the new, and new is old, and old is new when it comes to this regulator. And I'm going to explain exactly what I mean by that in just a second. Stick with me. So what the heck do I mean by old is new and new is old, or vice versa? And what I mean by that is this particular Scubapro regulator, the Mk19 D420, is a 2021 version of some regulators, both first and second, that have been out in the past. And the Mk19 was out in a previous version, and the design cues from the second stage D420 were actually out a number of years ago. Now, what Scubapro has done is they've taken some of those great aspects of the Mk19 as it was, and the Mark 17 and the Mark 25, and made the new Mark 19. And they took the older D350 and the D400 and made the D420. And some of the unique things about this particular regulator make it a really excellent regulator for those of you out there that are technical divers. You may be even military divers. And of course, if it's good for them, it's good for advanced divers and of course, the new divers that are out there. Now, let's talk a little bit about what makes the Mk19 and the D420 unique today. This particular Mk19 was actually developed in Italy by Scubapro's R&D department, and it was really developed in order to meet some of the needs and demands of technical divers in the world. And it was actually introduced over in Europe before it came here to the United States recently. Now, mainly because it is environmentally sealed, it of course is a great first stage for cold water diving or contaminated water diving. And of course that contaminated would be like a public safety team that's diving in very dirty water doing a car removal or some of the things that they do. It's also good for you ocean divers, saltwater diving, as well as cold water. And now I'm going to put a couple of links down below to one or two Scubapro videos that explain more about the differences between a environmentally sealed regulator and a non-sealed regulator, as well as a piston regulator and a diaphragm regulator, which this Mk19 is a diaphragm regulator. Now this Mk19 actually, if you look back, it took its and has taken its styling cues from the old Scubapro Mark V way back quite a few years ago. And of course, the nice thing about it is that's what I mean in the fact that today we can put our new technology benefits as far as CNC machining and flow testing and all the great things that we can do with computers now and take those older designs and put them into something more efficient or practical when it comes to breathability. A balanced first stage, it gives you almost effortless breathing no matter what depth you're at, because it senses that water pressure on the first stage and it adjusts the intermediate pressure coming down to the second stage. So the second stage, of course, senses your ambient pressure that you're breathing at. So if the hose, the intermediate pressure, is kept in that 130 to 150 range, let's say. And as you drop down, the demand goes from, and I'm just going to round off some numbers, 15 PSI at the surface, and maybe you're going to be going to 130 or something, and you've got something like 45 PSI off of that intermediate pressure versus 15. It's able to, and when I mean it, I'm talking about the first stage, it's able to actually raise that intermediate pressure is less of a percentage of whatever the second stage is utilizing. So that's one of the beauties of a balanced first stage. Of course, the Mk19 is similar. As a matter of fact, if you hold a Mk19 and you hold a Mk25, and you're not exactly positive exactly what you're looking at, it's kind of hard to tell the difference because, of course, the new Mk19 has a swivel on it, and the Mk25, being a piston regulator, also has a swivel on it, and they have very similar design cues as far as the first stage goes. Now, the swivel on the Mk19 can be used either up, what we call up, in other words, turret on top, or it can be turned down, turret down, totally up to you. It's got four ports on the turret that allow you to mount your primary hose, your alternate, your inflator hose. If you're using a dry suit, maybe a dry suit inflator hose off of those. It also has what they call a fifth port off the bottom. And that fifth port off the bottom is called a axial because it's in the axis of the regulator, an axial fifth port. And of course, it can be used for whatever you might happen to need it for. Now, the hose that this unit comes with, yeah, it's pretty standard. It's about a 29-inch hose. It is a hard rubber hose. It's not a flex. The turret helps with that. Scubapro is kind of big about having the hard rubber hoses versus braided hoses. It can be changed if you want to. And that's one of the beauties of this particular system is its adjustability. The compact size and, of course, breathing characteristics of the Mk19 make it one of Scubapro's elite regulators. Let's talk about the 420. One of the things about the 420, and I'm going to put a picture up here so you can see the D350 and, of course, the D400, and you're going to notice that even the one of the first ones that Scubapro came out with called the A1, they have some similar styling cues to it. And what do I mean by that is that the actual push button, like most of the regs, if we look at them and we look straight on, you're going to see a circle. The diaphragm is pretty much right in front of your mouth like this. Now, with the 420 and these D series, they tend to have that diaphragm a little further down, and they say it aids in the ability for the second stage to deliver air. So Scubapro is calling this a progressive flow control valve. And one of the other nice things is that you're not having to look for a second stage that is reversible. Yeah, I mean, most of you guys know that most second stages are not reversible. The 420 is reversible. You're able to put the hose in from the right, like what you see with this 420 right here, or you're able to put it in from the left, depending on maybe you're doing a side mount, maybe somebody's got a handicap you're trying to take care of. It's reversible. One of the other things you're going to notice on the 420, sometimes people call it a Venturi adjustment, and that is this thumb lever, and many people call it pre-dive or dive adjustment. And if you keep it forward, then it makes it less sensitive. It actually turns the air when it comes out of the valve and bumps it against the diaphragm before it turns and comes into your mouth. And if you pull it back, it changes that direction and allows the air, once it comes out of the control valve, and basically it points straight down your throat. So maybe you're swimming along, or maybe you're on a drift dive and you don't really need a whole bunch of air, then you can push this forward, save a little air, and then maybe you need to turn, swim across current or into a current. You can reach up and pull this back. I do this on many of the regulators that are adjustable like that I dive with when I go drift diving. Now, this particular casing on the D420 is a fiberglass reinforced case composite. It's really a tough piece of equipment. And one of the other things that you'll notice is that the way the vents are positioned, to direct the flow of bubbles more away. And actually inside, there's some design cues inside of this that help direct the flow of the bubbles away from the diver's face. One of the other things that I want to point out when we look at the 420, and again, I'm going to put some pictures up here so you can see in a little larger what I'm talking about, is when you look at this, you're going to notice that the purge button is down here on the bottom. And with this being angled, if you're diving, you've got this in your mouth, then you can reach and push and depress that purge button just because of the angle, which is pretty, you know, it's pretty cool, stuff. So that's a look at the new Scubapro Mk19 D420. I hope you guys have enjoyed the information. If you're new here, reach down and hit the subscribe button. We're getting real close to 3,000 subscribers. Love for you to be one of those. In addition, I want to encourage you, if you bought one of these new units and you're diving with it, put some comments down there. I had an interesting discussion, and the reason I suggest the comments, I had recently an interesting discussion with a gentleman from Russia about the benefits of, say, the Mark 25, the A700, the Mark 17, and G260. And how those particular regulators, and now the Mark 19, as far as a cold water diving regulator. So again, my name's Bob Collins, and like we always say here at Diver Supply, dive safe out there, and I appreciate you watching. Thanks again.